You know, the jobs back home, there's not a lot of room. In fact, there's no room for divas. No one's a superstar. You know, everyone's a human doing the work. And I think that breeds a really strong work ethic. And I think people that really, you know, take acting seriously, they get in that training ground and they, you know, they get to explore and experiment and push the boundaries of the creativity. And you do that for 4 years and learn the technicals of being on set all the time. You're just like, you're just a machine and you're pumped. You know, you want more, you want to do bigger, you want to continue to push yourself and see what you can achieve and how far you can go. And, you know, so that's a great thing about you go to the States and suddenly you're on set for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and you're like, wow, look what they can do with their money and their resources. And so what can I do in this world? How can I push myself further? And you get that adrenaline rush of like, oh, I got to step up again. I think you get addicted to the rush of the challenge of I have to meet this standard now, push myself, meet that standard. And you're constantly growing and expanding yourself and challenging yourself and seeing what's possible, what can you do. And I think that partnered with the no diva complex and complete work ethic, I think breeds, an army of Australian actors going over there and really giving it a good shot. And also you're spending all your money. You can't get a job because of visas and you've left all your family. You're a 14-hour flight away from everything you hold dear, you know, so it really separates the wheat from the chaff. Whereas I think if you're just born and bred in LA, you know, you can definitely take it seriously, but you're going to your mum's on the weekend, you have a part-time job and that like, no, I've put everything into this. I've literally sold my car back home. I can't just go home for the weekends and see my mom. Like, so you really have to throw it all out there. It's really all or nothing. And so I think again, that kind of breeds an attitude and breeds a bunch of people that really have to take the work seriously and really have to apply themselves and do whatever it takes to be as good as they can be to give themselves the best shot because of how much they've sacrificed and how much you have to do to be there and, you know, be lucky enough to have a shot at it, you know. But having said that, the couple of times, I know I've worked at home a lot more than you have since we left Home and Away, but there is something really wonderful about being in your accent and being with an Aussie crew and being in your environment, you know, it's really good soul food. And I know you'll take the right opportunity to go home and work. And I've loved the stuff that I've got to do back home as well. And it's great that we can do both now. And I think, you know, the world's getting smaller and smaller and it's becoming a global industry as much as it's becoming a global community. And so I think we're really lucky because, you know, back in the, you know, the days of when, what, like Heath Ledger and Melissa George, you know, the early Home and Aways were coming out, I think it was a lot harder for them. They didn't have Skype and Viber and, you know, wire over money. You know, it was even harder for them. So I still, like, count ourselves lucky at the, you know, where we are at. It's still totally hard, but it's still a lot more accessible to be able to live your dream, you know, and we're getting to do that to the fullest, I think.
Yes.
Yes. Good.